Dear students, here let us solve problems on odd efficiency of a transformer, which is the topic of your first module, single phase transformer. So the problem on odd efficiency of a transformer, let us have a look over here. Given problem statement is a 2300 bar 230 volts. Means here it is step down transformer. 500 kVA 50 hertz distribution transformer has core loss of 1600 watts at rated voltage and copper loss of 7.5 kilowatt full load condition. During the day it is loaded as follows, right? So let us see the loading condition here. So this whole row indicates percentage loading, then the second row indicates power factor condition, third row indicates how many number of hours you are going to connect the load. Okay, so for 0% loading, power factor is nil and it is 2 hours. 20% loading, whose power factor is 0.7 lakh and it is connected for 4 hours. Then 50% of the loading condition, whose power factor is 0.8 lagging and it is connected for 4 hours. Then 80% of the loading, its power factor 5 hours. 100% loading, is its power factor is 1 and it is connected for 7 hours. Then similarly, 125% loading, its power factor is 0.85 lag and it is connected for 2 hours. So totally here it is given for the duration of 24 hours. So it is given for the duration of 24 hours. So 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 plus 7 is 22, 22 plus 2 is 24. So in one whole day, that is 24 hours, how the load is utilized. So for 2 hours, 0% load. For 4 hours, 20% loading, that to 7.7 lagging power factor. For next 4 hours, 50% it will be loaded. Transformer is loaded for 50% and its power factor is 0.8 lag. Then similarly, for the next 5 hours, it is carrying the load of 80%, its power factor is 0.9 lakh. It is carrying for the next 7 hours, 100% load, its power factor is 1. And for the last 2 hours, it will carry 125% of the loading and its power factor is 0.85. With all these given conditions, you should calculate what determine the odd efficiency of the transformer. So write down all the given values. So the given values here are, iron loss PI is given as 1600 watts from the problem statement. And see here. Core loss of 1600 watts. Core loss means iron loss, which is constant throughout the day. That is 1600 watts. PI it is. PI is 1600 watts. And full load copper loss, PCUFL. Full load copper loss is given as 7.5 kilowatt. So PCUFL is 7.5 kilowatt. Then energy output formula here is kilovolt KVA into cos pi. Usually it is KVA into cos pi. Here the general basic formula for energy output is volt into ampere, that is VA cos pi into hours, because it is only VA cos pi means power, it will be power multiplied by time, that is hours, it will be energy. So energy output is given as VA cos pi into hours. Now calculate the, in order to calculate energy odd efficiency, formula is what? Output by input, output energy divided by input energy. So first you calculate output energy. Output energy for all 24 hours. So zero means what? So zero means for this period of time it is. So zero plus next percentage is what here? 200 divided by what is that? Next is percentage loading condition. Percentage loading condition you can see here. 20% it is connected. So make use of this formula. Energy, in order to calculate energy output, use this formula. Energy output is equal to VA cos pi into hours. So now first loading for 2 hours, it will be free from the load, that is 0%. So it is zero. Next it is loaded for 20%. So 20% means 0.2, that is 20 by 100, which is 0.2. And V into A, VA is 500 into 10 raised to 3. And what is the power factor for 20% loading? It is 0.7. So 0.7. Similarly in 0.7. And number of hours, how long it is connected? It is connected for 4 hours into 4. Plus, next it is 50%. 50% means 50 by 100. Next, VA cos pi. VA means 500 into 10 raised to 3 into cos pi. 50% cos pi is how much here? 0.8. 0.8. and hours, how long it is connected? It is connected for 4 hours. Similarly, you write for next load. Next load is what? It is connected for 80%. 80% means 80/100. 80/100 into VA. VA means 500 into 10 raised to 3, and its power factor is 0.9. It is connected for hours. Similarly, for the next load, it is connected. What is that? For the next load, what is the loading condition here? For the next load, it is connected for 100% means 1. 1 you can take. 1 into VA. What is VA? 500 into 10 raised to 3. And what is its power factor? Power factor is 1 here. And how long it is connected? 7. So for that sake, 500 into 10 raised to 3 into 1 into 7. And finally, at last, the next load is 125%. 125% means 1.25 into VA cos pi. VA means 500 to 10 raised to 3, cos pi means 0.85, and hours means 2. So for that, you can write here it as 1.25, that is 125/100 into VA, 500 into 10 raised to 3, cos pi is 0.85, and it is connected for 2 hours. So if you simplify whole this equation or the expression, then the energy output will be 7,442.5 kilowatt hour. Now next, this is my output energy. Then you calculate for iron loss. Iron loss is constant for throughout the 24 hours. So PI is given for us. So what is PI here? 1600. 1600 into 24. It will be 38.4 kilowatt hour. It will be 38.4 kilowatt hour. But the copper loss will be different for different loading conditions. So here, how many loading conditions are given in the problem? You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 different copper losses you should calculate here. So for the first load, here 0% load means here copper loss will be 0. Then you calculate copper loss for this, for this, for this, for this, and finally for this loading condition. Different 5 copper losses you have to calculate and multiply it with the same timing conditions. So then we will be getting copper loss in terms of energy. Okay. So first condition is no load, so no copper loss on no load. And second loading condition is 20%. 20% means the value of small n will be 0.2. And given is copper loss. Copper loss full load is given for us. Full load copper loss is given for us here as, what is that? 7.5 kilowatt. So this is 7.5 kilowatt is the full load copper loss. Now PCU, this is fractional load copper loss. So PCU for 20% loading is n square, because I square R means, I square, if it is appearing square, square number of current means, you should take loading condition as n square here into full load copper loss. N value is 0.2, 0.2 whole square into full load copper loss is 7.5 kilowatts. So 0.2 whole square into 7.5 kilowatt, the answer will be 0.3 kilowatt. And how long it is connected? It is connected for 4 hours. 20% loading, it is connected for 4 hours. So multiply that kilowatt information with 4 hours. So 0.3, already it is in kilowatts, multiply it with 4 to convert into energy. So 0.3 into 4 is 1.2 kilowatt hour. Similarly, calculate for next loading condition, which is 50%. 50% means n is 0.5. So PCU is 0.5 whole square into 7.5. So it will be 1.875 kilowatt. And it is connected for 4 hours. 1.875 into 4 is 7.5 kilowatt hour. Similarly, the fourth load is 80%. N is 0.8. Then copper loss will be 0.8 whole square into 7.5. That is equal to 4.8 kilowatt, which is connected for 5 hours. So it will be 24 kilowatt hour. Similarly, the next load is 100%. 100% means N value will be 1. So PCU is equal to PCUFL, that is 7.5 kilowatt. And how long it is connected? It is connected for 7 hours. So therefore, energy spent is 52.5 kilowatt hour. And with the last load, it is loading condition is 125%. 125% means N is equal to 1.25. So PCV is equal to 1.25 whole square into 7.5. This is full load copper loss. So kilowatt information of copper loss is 11.7187, and it is connected for 2 hours. So convert this power into energy. So multiply it with 2, which is connected for 2 hours. That is 11.7187 into 2, that will be 23.4375 kilowatt hour. So all these values, first one is 0, add all the 6 values. First one is 0, plus 1.2 plus 7.5 plus 24 plus 52.5 plus 23.4375. So this will give you total copper loss. Now total energy spent due to iron and copper loss means already we have calculated for iron loss here. So what is the iron loss information here? Iron loss is 38.4 plus total copper loss 38 plus 0 plus 1.2 plus 7.5 plus 24 plus 52.5 plus 23.4375. So all together if you add, then you will be getting total losses. And total losses means combination of, it is a sum of iron and copper loss. So the total iron and copper loss, that is total losses in the transformer, will be 147.0375 kilowatt hour, which is nothing but in terms of energy. So now we know that all the efficiency is given by total energy output in 24 hours divided by total energy output in 24 hours plus energy spent in 24 hours. It is as good as output by input. Input means what? Output plus total losses. Total loss, iron loss plus copper loss. But here it should be in terms of energy. So in order to get energy information, we are taking power multiplied with time. So total energy output in 24 hours. In the beginning, we have calculated what is the value of total energy output. It is 7,442.5. So 7,442.5, this is the total energy output which we are taking in the numerator. Similarly, 7,442.5 divided by total energy output, once again it will be same, that is 7,442.5 plus total losses. Total losses is sum of iron and copper loss, which is 147.0375 kilowatt hour. So substitute here and multiply it with 100 in order to convert into percentage, then all the efficiency of the transformer is 98.062%. Okay, all the efficiency of 98.062%.